Yeah, dear student, welcome back to the business study class. And today we are starting chapter 2, that is called principal of pulse of management. So you have gone through the success story of the several business enterprises, and they are successful because of the some basic strong principle decided by them, and they uphold and they are continuously following those principles. So one case study has been given for business principle of Toyota Motors. Clear? So see the first principle. Honor the language and spirit of law. Honor the language of the country in which they are working. Why? Because Toyota is an MNC, multinational company. Honor the language of that country and spirit of law. You know what the law of that land is saying? It has to be very well followed. And undertake open and fair corporate activities to be a good corporate citizen around the world. To follow the spirit of law, do not get involved in the unfair trade practices and reckless trade practices, and to become a good corporate citizen. Clear? Whole around the world, not in their own country. That is why you will see that Toyota is very well known for its automobile products across the globe, not only in the Japan, in the whole world. Clear? Second, respect the culture of that country. Clear? Now this is again very second good principle. Respect the culture and customs of every nation and contribute to the economic and social development through corporate activities in local communities. Clear? Respect the culture and tradition of that country. So you will always see the glimpse of Indian festival while they are advertising on the Indian television. They never show their Japanese culture because it's useless. You know, if they are working in India, they will follow the culture and customs of the India. So every advertisement is rotating around those custom and culture of that particular country. Clear? And contribute to the economic and social development. Besides following the culture and the tradition, they will also look for the social development of the country through corporate activities in local communities. Clear? So economic and social development is very much necessary, and it is the principle of the Toyota Motors. Clear? Third, very good principle again, to provide clean and safe products. That is why you will see they are having very limited number of models, but they are damn famous. Previously there was a model Toyota Qualis, afterward they launched Innova, then Innova Crysta. They are having SUV, MPV, hatchback car also, Toyota Corolla. Clear? So what they believe in? To provide clean and safe products and to enhance the quality of life everywhere. Clear? The moment you make quality products, you are also enhancing the quality of life around you. Clear? Fourth, create and develop advanced technologies. Create and develop advanced technologies. This is again very much necessary. Advanced technology and provide outstanding products and services that fulfill the needs of customers worldwide. Clear? See, their model one Toyota Fortuner is damn famous all around the world. It's known for their sport activities as well as for the adventurous activities. It is also used, this vehicle is also used for international traveling. If you go, there are some rules on which international travel is being permitted. So that vehicle is very well taken around the world for doing the international road travels. Clear? So this is very well necessary to create and develop advanced technologies and provide outstanding products and services that fulfill the needs of customers worldwide. Clear? So Toyota and Fortuner is not fulfilling the needs of their own country, but also the needs of different countries around the world. Clear? Next point, foster a corporate culture. Foster means to support. Foster a corporate culture, and that enhances the individual creativity and teamwork value while honoring the mutual trust and respect between the management and labor. Clear? We are developing a very
well culture of multinational corporations.
Clear? And developing a relation with their labor also. Clear? Next, pursue growth and harmony. See, you will not find anything typical in their principle. What they are have framed is a very common things. Pursue growth and harmony with global community through innovative management. They are not here in this country to destroy or to distort the any other car manufacturer. No, they are not here. They are just here to advertise or to sell their products. So, to pursue growth and harmony, they are not here for any type of the violence or to destroy anyone. With global community through innovative management. Clear? Work with business partners to work with their business partners in research and creativity to achieve stable long-term growth and mutual benefits. And are always open to the new partnership. They are not very much confined to their product. They are always open for the new partnership. And if any new good venture is available, they will definitely go for it. These principles will guide the company in its global vision for 2020. This global vision envisages the friendly technologies, respecting and working with different sections of the society and establishing an interactive relationship with the society. Okay? So these are the few basic guidelines. Business principles are the basic guidelines or thing which is going to be taken up by the enterprises to do the upliftment of their enterprises. Clear? For example, I will give you an example of Tata. What is the Tata's basic principle? Ki they will pay any type of tax to the government. They will never try to steal it. Clear? That is why you will see wherever there is a corrupt environment, Tata's has to stop their working environment. Clear? So many places they have not settled their factory. Why? Because corruption is there. So, because of the availability of the connection, they ask for the bribe and Tata's don't believe. They believe in making paying full tax to the government. So, this is the basic principle, and only this principle has uplifted the Tata. So, these are the certain principles. And Toyota is an innovative corporation, new corporation. It's more than 5 decades old. But the management principle are as old as civilization. There are so many things which you have studied earlier also. But what we have to see is the recent contribution in principle of management. Now we see the concept of principles of management. So managerial principle is a broad and general guideline for decision making. It's not a law. The principles of the management shall not be understood as a law. On the other hand, they are to be distinguished from the law. Because law will say the fixed things. But principles are the general guideline which help you in managing the affairs of the business enterprise. For example, if we consider an example of promotion of anyone. If you want to do the promotion of one person, so one manager may consider the qualification as the basis, oblique tenure, while another may consider the merit of that particular person. So other may follow the principle of merit, tenure, qualification, other may consider. So these are the general guidelines. They are not the binding of the person, but they are going to help you in taking the decision related to the business. And principle of the management are not as hard as the scientific rules. Clear? Because scientific rules are framed in the laboratories by making continuous experiment. They are based on the cause and effect relationship. But business principles are not as hard as to be like the scientific principles. Clear? Why? And why it is so? It is so because we are dealing with the humans, and the human mind is the most unsettling mind in the world. So you can't take out the word from a less educated or illiterate person by taking the help of the scientific principle. You can't be rigid. Clear? So it's management principle are to be distinguished from the scientific principles. Clear? For example, just if we consider an example of 20 years back. Clear? It was very difficult to manage a big organization. Why?
because there was total absence of information and communication technology.
Nowadays, it's very easy to handle a very large group of organization because the
help of the information and communication technology. Previously, in order to conduct the business meeting, you have to go outside. But with the advent of information and communication technology, right now you can do the meeting across the globe by sitting in your office. So, with the advent of the information technology, you are able to handle the large group of our business.
And at the same time, the principle of management should be distinguished from the techniques of the management. Principle of management are different from the techniques. Techniques are the things or tools, procedure or method which involve a series of steps to be taken to accomplish the desired goals. Principles are the guidelines to take decision or action while practicing techniques. Likewise, principles should also be understood as being distinct from values. Values are something which are acceptable or desirable. They are moral contribution. Principles are the basic truth or guideline for behavior.
This is just now you gave the example of Tata's. Tata's believe in making full payment of taxes to the government. They don't believe in stealing the tax. On the other hand, Reliance believe in stealing the tax. So they are doing their practice and Tata's are doing their practice. Everyone has its own success story. Clear?
Now we study the nature or of principle of management.
Yeah. Now we see the natures of principle of management. So nature, by nature we mean the simple characteristics, the qualities and characteristics of anything. So principle are general propositions which are applicable when certain conditions are present. They have been developed on the basis of observation and experimentation as well as personal experience of the managers, depending upon how they are derived and how effective they are in explaining and predicting managerial behavior. Clear? So see the first characteristic of nature. Universal applicability. Clear? The management principle are universally applicable, whole across the globe. Clear? It is applicable to all types of organization, whether big or small, private or public, whether commercial or charitable, political or philanthropic, any type of the activity. The management principle or principle of management are having universal applicability across the globe. And they act as a general guideline. They are not hard or rigid like a law of scientific principles. These are the general guidelines which help in the conduct of your business. And they do not provide the straight-jacket solution to every type of organization. What it will provide you is the general guideline. How they are formed, how principles of management are formed, clear? By practice and experimentation. By practice and experimentation. Now what does it mean? Simple, in 95% cases, money is the best motivator. Money is the best motivator. Clear? This simple means if you give some money to any person, he or she is ready to work in your organization in 95% cases. But what about the 5% cases? When a person has reached a certain level, it's not possible to make him bend for money. That person is not going to bend against you. Clear? So the principles are formed by practice and experimentation. Still, they are not foolproof. They are not going to provide a straight-jacket solution because nowadays business is very complex. Clear? Very complex and dynamic, and as a result of many factors. Clear? Next is flexible. Management principles are highly flexible because, as I am telling you, they are dealing with the human. Human mind is the most unstatic thing in the world. Clear? So they are not as hard as scientific rules because scientific rules are derived in the laboratory. Clear? While the management principles are derived from practice and experimentation amongst the humans. Next is mainly behavioral. Management principles are mainly behavioral.
They aim at influencing the behavior of human beings. Therefore, principle of management are mainly behavior in nature. While the scientific principles are practical in nature because they are developed in laboratories. It is just a matter of emphasis. Moreover, principle enable a better understanding of the relationship between human and material resources and accomplishing organizational purpose. Next is cause and effect relationship. Now, what does it mean, cause and effect relationship? The principle of management are intended to establish relation between the cause and effect so they can be used in similar organization in large number of cases. Clear? As such, they tell us if a particular principle was applied in a particular situation, that would be likely effect. The principle of management are less than perfect since they mainly apply to human behavior. Clear? Next, management principle are contingent. Contingent means the meaning of the contingency is doubtful. So the application of principle of management contingent or dependent upon the prevailing situation at particular point of the time. The application of principle has to be changed as per the requirement. Clear? For example, employees deserve a fair salary or fair remuneration. Now, what is fair remuneration is a question of fact. Clear? And it has been determined by multiple factors. And they include contribution of the employee, paying capacity of the employer, and also the prevailing wage rate for the occupation under consideration. Clear? So these are the certain points regarding to the nature of principle of management. I hope this is clear to you. Thank you.